Hello again, guys. It's Chris. From ancient cheese, that's right, cheese, to mysterious long walls, join me as I reveal to you 9 of the most bizarre archaeological finds ever. Number 9, Ancient Massacre. A group of archaeologists went to Sweden in 2010 to study a city from the 5th century. As they started to explore all of the houses, they found a body on the floor of one. Or more accurately, well, skeleton. This struck the scientists as odd because it should have been buried. Then, as they went to more houses, more bodies showed up unburied on the floors of the houses. Upon examining the bodies, they realized that the bones had markings of weapons upon them. It dawned on us that this was actually a massacre, said Clara Alfsdotter, a graduate student at Linnaeus University in Sweden and an archaeologist with the Bohuslän Museum. They were basically going from door to door killing everyone, from young children to older individuals. Further examination showed that the attack was done quietly and with maximum efficiency in order to get the job done and keep going swiftly. One even likened the attack to something out of Game of Thrones or even Vikings. You know, after all, they are in Sweden, so pretty close. At the time, only about 5-10% of the site had been excavated, so many more bodies could remain, but at present, there are no clues as to what really happened. Number 8. Screaming Mummies. In 1886, a famed archaeologist named Gaston Maspero was doing work in Egypt, and as his job as head of the Egyptian Antiquities Service, he was examining mummies and taking down notes on them. When he opened one particular one, however, he found that the mummy was screaming. This wasn't a living person or being, it was indeed a mummy in a sarcophagus, but the pose and posture of the mummy made it look like it was screaming. This naturally led to much speculation as to how this could happen, for usually mummies are so properly prepared that they actually have to be moved out of the state that they've been in for centuries. Degradation like this doesn't happen in mummification, or so they thought. Ideas of torture or being murdered before put in the coffin were thrown out by scientists. The truth, however, was much simpler than that. The process for mummification wasn't followed properly. When we die, our body goes rigid via the process of rigor mortis. However, after a while, our body relaxes and allows all the muscles in our body to elongate once more. And this is no different with mummies. And because of that, if the jaw isn't fastened, which is a practice in proper mummification, it'll go slack and then open. And without skin or muscles to give context, it looks like a screaming mummy. Rather weirdly, after this particular find, more screaming mummies were discovered all over the world. And some were found to have actual jaw straps on the mummy that broke, causing the condition upon being found. Number 7. Holy Jar. If you go to the Museum of Ontario Archaeology, you'll find a clay jar that was intentionally made with holes in it. Not one hole just at the top, mind you, but rather holes littered throughout the jar itself. Ironically, the jar, when found, was actually shattered and had to be reassembled, which led to the discovery of its unique form. Just as odd is that no one is exactly sure where the jar came from. It was found in an area near a crater in World War II. And it was in a storage room full of artifacts from Iraq via the city of Ur. But despite knowing that, it's unlike any jar ever found, and no one can place its origin or creator. The curators at the Ontario Museum even went and talked to other experts of other cultures to see if they recognized the style or the form, or even the origin point, but no one could give them a true answer. Number 6. Nazca Lines. In Peru are a series of shapes and formations made into the ground by an ancient tribe called the Nazca. Appropriate, these formations are called the Nazca Lines. These geoglyphs are found within one of the high deserts of Peru, and their shape, scale, and detail have left many both impressed, horrified, and a little confused. At ground level, you won't see anything. But when you go up in the sky, the true forms of the Nazca lines emerge. You'll see basic shapes, but then you'll also see birds and other animals. And then you might even see some stylized shapes that resemble humans. The two biggest questions when it comes to the Nazca lines are why and how. While it's fair to say it's not impossible to make such lines as these, to do it in the ancient times, when the estimated creation is put between 1 and 700 AD, is undoubtedly a challenge. but the Nazca did it. And they continued to do it. Not only did they do it, they did it with extreme precision. There's one line that actually goes 9 miles in length, and it's perfectly straight. A feat that's even more impressive when you hear that these were done by hand. There have been many theories as to why the Nazca lines were created. Some say that they're symbols of their gods. Some say that they're prisons for monsters or signals to beings in the sky. And the truth is, no one knows for sure what the truth is. Number 5. Range Creek Treasures. The Wilcox family held a secret for quite some time at their ranch in Utah. Called Range Creek, the family ranch held a large collection of tools, paintings, houses, and more from an ancient tribe of Native Americans called the Fremont. They lived in the area around 1,000 years ago. And when the family came onto the land, they found everything and worked very hard to try and keep it a secret. And they did so until one of the remaining family members sold it to the Utah Museum of Natural History. The biggest mystery of the items found at the ranch was that of the wall paintings made by the Fremont. Because while there were many identifiable items and pictures to take note of, some of them are beyond what should be in the area, including large figures that aren't shaped like humans. Were these symbols of their gods, or maybe of creatures they claim to have seen in their lands at one time? And why put them with other animals like goats in the pictures? What were they trying to convey? If you've got a theory, how about you pop it in the comments below? Number 4. Moa Claw, New Zealand, 1886. A group of archaeologists went to Mount Owen to examine and observe the underground complex of tunnels that lie beneath the mountain. Upon finding a large pile of bones, they found a claw that seemed to resemble a creature from the ancient past, the upload moa. The bird was flightless but incredibly tall. Some even say it was over 9 feet in height. The bird creature was said to be extinct because humans, the Maori, who were the first to arrive on the island of New Zealand, saw them as a great source of meat and thus wiped them out. The interesting thing about the claw, though, was that it was very preserved and even looked fresh. So how did this claw get under the mountain? The preservation of the claw is also a topic of conversation, as none of the other bones that were found in the cave were anywhere close to how good the claw was preserved. A popular theory is the moa species is actually still alive, and that the claw is proof of this fact. But since a full-on moa hasn't been seen in hundreds of years, it is still a mystery. Number 3. Jordan Wall. There is a wall in the country of Jordan, but no one knows its origin or its purpose. Not even with all the technology and references we have to the past. In 1948, when a British diplomat was flying over the country of Jordan, he looked down at the ground to notice a wall that wasn't just there, it was huge. In fact, it was 93 miles long. Just as puzzling, despite the wall having towers, 100 of them in fact, it was only 3 feet tall, which meant that it wouldn't have been a viable defense against an invading army or even robbers or thieves. Furthermore, there are parts of the wall that aren't connected to the rest. Some even run parallel to the wall itself, which is a very unusual way to create a wall of any kind. Research has been done on the wall itself, and estimates put the creation of it between 312 BC to 750 AD. As for who made the wall, no one's really sure, just as no one is sure as to why it was made in the first place. Number 2. Egyptian Cheese. Back in 2018, a group of archaeologists went to Egypt and apparently found the oldest intact sample of cheese ever discovered. Then they wrote about this discovery in an article for Analytical Chemistry. The cheese they found was 3,200 years old, which meant that something had to preserve it for that long. The discovery itself was made when the team were exploring the tomb of Pitamis, mayor of Memphis, the ancient capital of Egypt. During their exploration, they came across some broken jars, and inside the jars was a mass that would later be identified as cheese. To figure out what the mass was, they actually had to dissolve it, and then run tests on the substances that made up the mass. The material analyzed in this study is probably the most ancient archaeological solid residue of cheese ever found to date. So that begs the question, how did the cheese survive for that long a period? The answer is that the type of cheese and where it was contained helped it last for 3 millennia. The cheese that ancient Egyptians had was high in moisture, and because the cheese itself was in a jar inside of a tomb, the moisture couldn't escape, thus drastically slowing down the aging and spoiling process. Though I still don't think I'd eat it. You? Number 1. Stone Age Tools in India. The common theory of human evolution is that 60,000 years ago, a group of people from Africa came out and started to populate the world. But now, that theory is in question. A dig site in southern India has found tools from very long ago, specifically over 200,000 years ago. These tools were very much Stone Age, and yet they were over 150,000 years before the group of Africans came out of the continent. So how did they get there? This clearly shows that populations with this culture were present in most parts of South Asia, adapting to local factors and with tool types evolving and changing through time, says Shanti Papu of the Sharma Center for Heritage Education in India. The new theory that is being formed is that the Homo sapiens of Africa actually left the continent in waves, with some going out hundreds of thousands of years before the others for one reason or another. An initiative is taking place to try and find more ancient Stone Age tools, date them, and figure out what happened and when. Should more be found, a new timeline of human life could be made. Thanks for watching. What did you think of these archaeological finds? Which one was the most interesting to you? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.